Hi, this is Scott Garibay, and today I want to talk about, specifically, I would like to talk about the new, a new version of Dungeons & Dragons that now exists, in my opinion, which is, it is specifically Dungeons & Dragons, oh my gosh, Dungeons & Dragons BE. All right, so here, I hear you. What are you talking about, Scott? All right, so here we go. There are 5 acknowledged editions of Dungeons & Dragons, okay? Those acknowledged editions are D&D 1E, D&D 2E, D&D 3E, D&D 4E, D&D 5E. If you ask any historian how many editions of Dungeons & Dragons there are, the vast majority and the most talented of those historians who are trying to give an answer that a layman would understand, right, would say there are 5 editions of Dungeons & Dragons. And all the other historians would understand why that was said, okay? I am saying that there was already one additional edition to that, in addition to that. And then I'm saying that just recently there's a second lettered edition that just was made. So what are they? Okay. So the Dungeons & Dragons D&D AE, A letter A, edition is the Young Adventurer's Guide to Dungeons & Dragons. It's 5 books. It's printed as a YA series of books, but in every single book, there is 2 to 3 pages of rules. They're not listed as rules. That's what they are. Any DM will recognize that they are telling people how to play Dungeons & Dragons in an officially printed Wizards of the Coast Dungeons & Dragons book. Dungeons & Dragons on the cover, Dungeons & Dragons WotC published, it's an edition. It is not recognized by Wizards of the Coast as an edition because it is actually a stealth edition. I don't think they want people to understand that they created a new edition with the Young Adventurer's Guide. But if you are paying attention and you know your Dungeons & Dragons history, this is absolutely a new edition. It's a new way to play the game. There's no two ways about it. And I would say that this is similar to a situation where there's something created, but the creator doesn't acknowledge the thing, right? There's a word for that. It's a terrible word. I don't think we haven't replaced that terrible word, right? But right now you just need to use a whole lot of words to say it. It is a created thing that the creator does not acknowledge as their thing, right? And that's what we have. So I think that Young Adventurer's Guide is a lettered edition of Dungeons & Dragons. It is Dungeons & Dragons AE, okay? I thought that for a while. Let's talk about Dungeons & Dragons BE. Dungeons & Dragons, the letter B, edition, right? That is the new Jovenshire puppet edition. What? So Jovenshire, on YouTube, did a puppet campaign of Dungeons & Dragons, right? It is a fun, lighthearted Dungeons & Dragons game, okay? Why is it special? It's very special because Wizards of the Coast said, go watch this Dungeons & Dragons game. So Wizards of the Coast acknowledged what was happening on this puppet show as a Dungeons & Dragons game. That's a big deal, right? I can go put whatever nonsense I want up with a bunch of players. And if Wizards of the Coast doesn't come along and christen that and anoint it, it doesn't mean anything, right? If I say that my game's a Dungeons & Dragons game, it's not a Dungeons & Dragons game until Wizards of the Coast acknowledges it's a Dungeons & Dragons game. And with the Jovenshire Puppet Adventure campaign, that is acknowledged by Wizards of the Coast as a Dungeons & Dragons game, right? Well, Jovenshire made his own version of the rules, which allowed people who had no idea how to play Dungeons & Dragons to play Dungeons & Dragons. One of the players was like, no, I've never played this before in my life, right? And he said, listen. And so Jovenshire, the host, right, and the YouTube channel creator, he said, listen, what's going to happen is they all have character sheets, but they're just going to roll a D20 for every single roll in this game, okay? And I'm going to tell them what happens. That's very different than Dungeons & Dragons. Now, if Jovenshire was just some oddball, you know, running his YouTube channel, nobody would care. But Wizards of the Coast permissioned this. They anointed this. They said, this is Dungeons & Dragons. So you can go watch that, and then you can use Jovenshire's rule set as a new edition of Dungeons & Dragons, and you could tell anybody you want, in my opinion, in my humble opinion, that you're playing Dungeons & Dragons, because it was officially permissioned by Wizards of the Coast. That's my opinion. What do you think? Do you think that the Dungeons & Dragons editions include D&D 1E, D&D 2E, D&D 3E, D&D 3E, 4E, D&D 5E, and D&D AE, as I defined it, and D&D BE, as I defined it, because they were both literally published and permissioned by Dungeons & Dragons? I'd love to hear your thoughts. Let me know in the comments below. Please consider liking and subscribing, and have a wonderful millennium.